Thank you guys very much. Before I start my talk, I wanted to say how excited I am to be here with all of you guys. I've been a part of the Effect community for a very long time, and the fact that we're all here is just amazing to me. A huge shout out to all the organizers of this conference. So if we could just give like a quick round of applause for all of them. Thank you guys. So, I'm Maxwell Brown. I've been a part of the community for a while now, and this is my lightning talk, which is entitled Effect CLI, a love letter to developers tired of settling for less. So before I get started with talking about all the cool things that we have in Effect CLI, I wanted to talk for a moment about my motivation behind building this library. So you folks might think that I built this library because I wanted to, I don't know, improve the developer experience on the command line. Or maybe, you know, at the time, I wanted to build the first application level framework for Effect. We didn't have any at that point. But the reality is actually a lot simpler. I'm just kind of lazy. And I don't mean lazy in the sense that I'm not willing to do work. I mean, I'm lazy when it comes to the boring things that we as developers are often saddled with having to do, even though we might not necessarily have to. And our software can maybe help with some of that. So at the time, before writing Effect CLI, I had a need for a CLI framework. I wasn't happy with any of the frameworks I found out there, and so Effect CLI was born. And today, I'm really hoping to show all of you how you can improve your productivity by 10x on the command line, yes, 10x, by utilizing Effect CLI for your CLI applications. But to do that, I needed a good example. Now, some of you might know, because I can't stop talking about it, that I recently became a father. Woo! And, thank you. And I've made it recently, very recently, I've made it my mission in life to become the supreme, undisputed grandmaster of the dad joke. And so I thought it would be very appropriate for our example application today to be a CLI that fetches dad jokes for us. So you can see here, and I've affectionately titled our CLI the Dadinator. Our CLI has two commands. We've got the random command subcommand, which fetches us a random dad joke, and then we've got the search subcommand, which fetches us a dad joke based on some search term that we provide. Optionally with a limit, but let's be honest, when would we ever want to limit the number of dad jokes we have access to? And before I keep going with this talk, maybe we can take a quick peek at how the CLI works. You guys can all see that. Maybe I'll make it a bit bigger. One second. Okay. So perhaps we'll fetch a random dad joke first. Thank you. Actually, is this one working? Hello? Okay. And recently, I believe Sebastian made some significant quality of life improvements to this CLI. So let's see if it works.
Okay, Daddy, do you know this one yet? I wear a stethoscope so that in a medical emergency I can teach people a valuable lesson about assumptions.
Okay. Don't worry, there'll be more at the end. There'll be more at the end. So, with that, let's take a look at... I want to start by taking a look at the API that Effect CLI provides. I know it may not be the sexiest feature of the library, but we provide an extremely easy to use, highly composable, and type safe CLI from this library, not to toot my own horn. But the full spec of the Dadinator CLI that we just used is on this slide, and maybe we can go through it very quickly. So, we've got an option, a command line option that we're specifying here, which is a limit, which is an integer. We're giving it an alias, we're providing a description, and we're setting a default. And now we've got the full spec for our limit option. We've also got a command line argument, so what we basically use to represent positional arguments in Effect CLI, which we're calling term, which is a piece of text. And this also has a description associated with it. And we're providing both the limit and the term to our search subcommand. And in our search subcommand, you can see that we're attaching a handler as well. And we're using, in the handler, we receive the parsed value of limit and term, which we can use to perform some logic in order to fetch our, in order to search for our dad jokes. We also have the random command here, which attaches a handler to fetch random dad jokes. And then both of these subcommands get attached to the parent datinator command, the root command, the register to subcommands. And with 20 lines of code, we've fully specified our CLI application. And all we have to deal with is the actual application level logic, which is pretty cool. The other thing that this library gives us, because we've specified our full CLI app in code, we can do a lot of things for the developer. I mentioned that I'm very lazy. One of the things that I hate doing is writing documentation. And because you've specified the full structure of your CLI application in code, we can actually generate all the help documentation for the CLI for you. So I've taken a small snippet of the search subcommand documentation here. You can see we can generate a full usage statement for the commands that you specify. We also have the documentation for the arguments that you've provided, as well as the options. And in addition, you'll notice that the custom descriptions provided also show up in the generated documentation. But we don't stop there. We also generate for you completion scripts. Thank you. Effect CLI is, I think, one of the only TypeScript CLI frameworks out there that can generate completion scripts successfully for all of the major shells that exist. I might be missing a few. Some of you use weird shells, I don't know. But and the other thing about the completion scripts that we generate is that they're fully static. A lot of the CLI frameworks out there have to reinvoke your CLI application to get the generated completions out. We can do it statically because of the way that you build up your CLI application. So oftentimes the completions on the command line become pretty performant. Maybe we can take 30 seconds and I can show you folks. So, thank you. So we can very quickly start up a fish shell. You're welcome, Johannes. I swore to myself I wouldn't mention Johannes in my talk, and here we are. So we can basically use the completions flag, which is available with all CLI applications, specify the shell that we want, and pipe it out to a file that will hold the shell script. Obviously, this would usually be going in whatever the completions directory is appropriate for your shell. But once we've done this, for our little example here, we can source these completions. And just like that, we've got generated completions for our CLI that we can tab through, because I'm also too lazy to type. and again, flags will show up here. I'm working on positional arguments as well. We don't quite handle those extremely well yet, but you kind of get the idea, thank you very much, Anjana, of some of the other things that we can generate for you. And the feature of Effect CLI that I'm personally most proud of is also the feature that highlights my dedication to not writing documentation. With wizard mode in Effect CLI, you don't even need documentation because you can have your CLI applications walk your users through them automatically. And I think maybe this is best exemplified by just me showing you. So let's exit our fish shell because who really uses fish anyways? Just I think I can do this one-handed. So, oops. With the with every CLI application, with every Effect CLI application, we get this wizard flag. And once we start the wizard, you're automatically dropped into a prompt-based wizard, which will guide your users through your CLI application. The prompts that are generated are specific to your CLI. They're completely based on the commands and options and arguments that you provide. And so maybe we can take a quick walk through the Datinator CLI from the perspective of a user who's never used it before. So looking at the instructions, this wizard mode is going to take us through constructing commands for the Datinator CLI. We need to answer all the prompts for the wizard. And you can see at the bottom, the first thing we need to do is, because we have subcommands and we don't have options or arguments on the root command, first thing we need to do is select which command we want to execute. So let's try the search subcommand this time. Like I said. So once you're in a command wizard, the wizard will detect whether you have options or arguments for that particular command and will prompt you to provide those things. In this case, like I said, limit, it's an integer. It's the maximum number of dad jokes we want to fetch. Why would you ever want to limit this? I don't know. So let's just go with the default. I haven't tested this. No. And then we also have a command line argument. So you can see now we're dropped into the args wizard. We need to provide a search term. And again, the help documentation that's present with the help flag is presented to the user here as well. So maybe we can find some jokes about hipsters. I don't know. Does anybody else have any better search terms we can use?
Cats.
Ah, good idea. Cats. Oh my God, I don't know how many dad jokes this is gonna bring back, but. So once you're done with wizard mode, we have the option of, if you noticed as we were executing the wizard mode, we do have the command that we're building up provided to us, and it incrementally updates as we answer the prompts in wizard mode. And then once we're finished, we're presented with the full command, which a user can copy and paste and run, but we can also have the wizard run the command for us.
Okay, Daddy, have you heard these ones before? Dad joke, it. 07 bucks or 5 TFXC.
Like I said, I did not test this ahead of time, so here we are.
Scratch paper. Dad joke.
Okay, let's just. I have no idea how many times this is coming back. I know I'm over time. I want to just close out by saying there's a ton of other features in Effect CLI that we've been working really hard on. We've really made it our mission to help you all be as lazy as I am. We have tons and tons of things you can do using config values as fallbacks, which is really helpful for taking values out of the environment for default values. Sharing parent commands with options and args with child commands, which is a feature we'd been asked about numerous times by Johannes. The ability to use args and options to configure the environment for the command, the whole prompt module, which wizard mode is built upon, tons more features. We have a lot of ideas for features in the future. With that, I encourage you all to try out Effect CLI when you have to build your next CLI application, and then you can all thank me for building this library. Wait. Sorry. 10 seconds more. Just kidding, don't thank me. Thank you all very much for being here. If you want the code, it's on my GitHub for this CLI, and thank you all very much for your time. I really appreciate it.